Foundation.
Recycled Art Project voting, students going to state championship, and new info on the spring impact site.
And guess what? Time news starts now. Good morning, Titans. Today is Thursday, March 2nd, 2023. Meteorological spring. Did you know that? They call it meteorological spring.
Did not
March,
know that.
Even though spring doesn't really start till the 20th or 21st or something. Anyways, I am Mr. Trout.
And I am Zachary Baraga. Let's get started with the morning pledge of allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
The science and film class completed a recycled art project where they had to take all recyclable materials such as cardboard, plastic bottles, etc., things like that, to make an art project. This was for the conclusion of their solid waste pollution unit that culminated with watching the movie WALL-E. I like that, Ava, you know. Please go to the link that your teachers have provided to vote for your favorite project. And we want everybody to vote here. And they put the link, hopefully the teachers put them in their classrooms, but if not, we have also put the link in our Titan News Google Classroom. So if you haven't joined our Titan News Classroom, the code is 5QIIE40. And the link to vote will be pinned at the top there. So it's also a good to be in there, because then you'll get a link to our news show every day. What could be better than that? So we created a slideshow of the projects to vote it on, and we have it right here.
If you sign up to go onto the American Sign Language field trip to Kent on March 16th, please see Miss Maddie in room B221 or B236 to get a permission slip. Also, Nakia Herman, Simone Witt, and a 4x200 meter relay team of Anaya Polis, Ayana Alves, Kenya Simone, and Herman have qualified for the OATCCC Indoor High School State Champions meet on March 4th at the Spire Institute in the Geneva, Ohio. Senior Nakia Herman has qualified for her third indoor state championship meet in the 60-meter dash. Her time of 6.63 seconds is the current school record and the sixth fastest time in Division I. Congratulations.
Also, sophomore Simone Witt has qualified for her first indoor championship meet in the shot put with a distance of 37 feet, 10.5 inches, which is also the school record. So congratulations on that. That's pretty awesome. And is the fourth furthest throw in Ohio. The 4x200-meter relay team, oh, we already said that, didn't we? Or no, Vanea Palos, Ayana Alves, Nakia Herman, and Kenya Simpson set the school record with a time of 1 minute 47.43 seconds, which ranks them 14th in the state.
Did you know you're invited to the James F. Pye Senior Community Art Exhibit? Start W Art Com presents Black Women Empowerment 2. The event will be held on Saturday, March 4th, 2023 at the Lorain County Urban League. Address 200 Middle Ave, Elyria, from 3 p.m. to 5 p.m. The themes are Afro-Hispanic connection and Black women of empowerment from a historical perspective. The exhibit and events are free to the public. There will be a community speaker, live performing artists, and potluck dinner served during the event. Please come support, share, and encourage our youth and enjoy the special evening. Any questions, call Jeff Pye at 440-315-2293.
Are you looking to meet new friends? Are you looking to improve your ACT score? Well, you should be. Do you want to learn how to study and sharpen up those test-taking skills? Is there a college or career you're interested in learning more about? Well, look no further than the Spring Impact Session. Impact is back for its spring session starting on March 20th. All Impact sessions will be held in the library after school from 2:30 to 5:30. This 8-week program is free to all students, and you can sign up by scanning the QR code on your screen. Right down there, wrong way. There. Okay, if you attend at least 30 sessions of Impact, you will earn a $200 stipend.
Oh, wow.
Where's Davion? To spend on whatever you want and be eligible to go on one of our two summer trips in June. To learn more about Spring Impact, you can email Miss Buck at rbuck@collegenowgc.org. She's got the bucks, Miss Buck. Or stop by the College Now office located in C211. I won't see you there, but I hope you go. I hope you attend. Oh, so here's a special announcement. So when I say, let's go to camera two. Can we go to camera two?
Camera
control room, yes. Yesterday, I understand you did something special.
Mm-hmm.
And we have a little video about it, okay?
Oh, wow.
Let's roll the tape.
Thank you much. Thank you very much, Senator Rogner. Chair now recognizes Senator Manning for a point of personal privilege.
Thank you, Mr. President. I want to recognize Zachary that was shadowing us today from Lorain High School. Before coming down, he said he absolutely loves government, so hopefully we did not ruin that for you today. But more specifically, he loves education policy, so this is a great day for him with Senate Bill 1 being here. So we want to welcome Zachary to the Senate. Please give him a warm welcome.
Thank you. The chair now recognizes.
Oh, that was pretty cool. You want to tell us about what you got to do there yesterday?
Yes. So I got to shadow Senator Manning and Representative Joe Miller yesterday at the Ohio State House. This was for the reason of spreading my love for government and education. I got to talk to Senator Manning a lot about our issues in the school and issues that don't get talked about a lot. Also in there, you may not see me, but I was actually on the floor of the Senate State House.
So I was in Columbus yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
How did you get about getting to go on this trip?
Well, I just sent an email to Senator Manning
saying
some of my concerns of Lorain High School.
Oh,
and
really?
He just decided to call me.
Well, that was pretty awesome. You had a good time then?
Mm-hmm.
All right. You bring back any money for
I
the
did
school
not.
Or something? I don't know. I don't know what Senate Bill 1 is either. I guess I better study up. Mr. Cawthon, help us out.
Yes, Mr. Coffin.
Okay, also yesterday, a kind of bittersweet news, because they played a really good game, but we wanted to shout out the boys basketball team. Their season ended. They even had a shot, a last second shot, that unfortunately didn't fall. So, but it was a great game. Shout out to Asaya, a good season. Looking for big things next year. Asaya is our floor manager right now, so great job.
Good job, Asaya. All
right, you can go to three.
Team Aries 8609Z is our first high school team to be competing in the Ohio VEX Robotics State Championship. This is the first year for Lorain High School to have a high school VEX team competing. This all-senior team has been working extremely hard all season. Wish them the best of luck. Go Jonathan, Madison, John, and Miguel. Give it all you have. You are making Lorain High School, LCS, and the city of Lorain proud. Also, Lorain High Titans honor kindness of self, others, and the environment. We are tolerant. We support each other. We seek to spread kindness, not hate. The Lorain High campus is a nonviolent, sacred space for all to learn, grow, and achieve excellence. Rise together, Titans. Greatness is in us. Staff, if you have any announcements you would like to see on Titan News, be sure to send us an email at titannews@lorainschools.org.
All right, I got my dad joke ready.
Okay,
let's hear it. Here we go. What's the difference between a poorly dressed man on a tricycle and a well-dressed man on a bicycle? Anyone?
Mm-hmm.
Attire. It's kind of a pun too, you know what I mean?
I get
They're dressed differently, their attire.
Well,
sometimes you gotta explain these things for
while we sit with that joke. Did you know 5 out of 4 people admit that they're bad at fractions?
Gotcha.
That's all we have for today. Be kind to yourself, be kind to others, and be kind to our environment. Go Titans.
Have a great day.